How do we know how languages are related? When two languages share some things in common, they might be related, but they also might not be. How do we know? When looking to see if languages are related, we look for words in the two different languages that are similar in both meaning and sound. But we have to be careful. There are two ways languages can end up with these pairs without being related at all. One is borrowing. The word for chocolate is very similar across a whole range of languages that aren't related to each other. It's similar because all those languages borrowed the word. It originally comes from Nahuatl, an Aztec language, and spread to others after explorers brought it back to Europe in the 1500s. Another way languages end up with words that seem related is by pure dumb chance. Sometimes languages just happen to hit on the same sequence of sounds for the same thing. The Spanish word for to look happens to be a lot like the Japanese word for to look. These coincidences happen more than you might think. After all, there are only so many sounds the human vocal tract can make. There's bound to be some accidental overlap. Language relationship is determined not just by finding similarities, but by finding systematic similarities. So the English word ship is similar to the German word Schiff. But it's not just that those two words are similar. It's that you find a P corresponding to an F through the vocabulary, and a D corresponding to a T, and th corresponding to d. In this way, English and German show a family resemblance. So what about all those English words that look like French words? There are tons of them, but you just don't find the same kind of systematic correspondences for those. Sure, there are some, but not many. Plus, our words from French have to do with the domain of high civilization. They are chocolate words. We borrowed them less than 1,000 years ago. Not so long ago, in the grand scheme of things. In contrast, our Germanic words harken back to the pre-civilized basics. Water, earth, stone, heart, blood, birth, death. We did not borrow these essential words from German. Rather, both German and English evolved from a common ancestor. They are siblings or cousins. They belong to a whole family of descendants, including Dutch, Swedish, Icelandic, and Gothic. By studying the sound correspondences across these languages and applying consistent sound change rules, we can actually work out what this mystery ancestor, Proto-Germanic, looked like. In the case of French's language family, the Romance languages, we already know what the ancestor language looked like. It was Latin. This method of looking for systematic correspondences allows us to peer even further back in time and see how whole language families are related to each other. It turns out, Latin and Proto-Germanic themselves have a common ancestor. This was one of the great discoveries of the 18th century, when scholars noticed that the classical Indian language Sanskrit had consistent similarities to Latin and Greek. They eventually uncovered systematic correspondences among a wide range of languages that spanned continents, working out a very ancient common ancestor known as Proto-Indo-European. It turns out English does have a family relationship to French, but it goes much further back to a much more distant ancestor. So, on the surface, French and English words for heart or hound don't look similar at all. But it is possible to see how the reconstructed Proto-Indo-European words caird and coon could, through intermediate historical steps, end up as English and French. How does K become H? K is a breathy sound made toward the back of the mouth. So is H. They started being pronounced differently in those ancestor words before Proto-Germanic split from Latin. These kinds of correspondences are harder to find and confirm, but it helps that the languages of the Indo-European family have a rich historical record of surviving documents going back through centuries of language change. Not every language family is so lucky, but a lot can still be accomplished using the comparative method in the absence of such a record. We can show how geographically distant languages are related to each other in families like Udo-Aztecan in the Americas, Bantu in Africa, or Uralic, which spans from Europe to Asia and Siberia. Every language is a history. The comparative method, carefully applied, lets us travel back in time further than any written record of that history.